In this video, we'll go through the topic design of turnouts. A turnout after branching off from the main track may run into various directions, of which running parallel to the original track is most common. So we know that there are different types of turnout. So sometimes the track may get entirely diverted from the existing track, and sometimes they may run parallel to the original track. Okay. So this calculation of turnout, the design of turnout, is based on three factors, and the three factors include the methods of calculating various leads. Okay, the various leads include the curve lead, the switch lead, and the crossing lead. I'll tell you each lead in the next slide. Then the methods employed for crossing angle. Crossing angle is what? It is that alpha angle. When you are having that crossing, you'll be having a, even if it is an acute crossing or if it is an obtuse crossing, you have an angle over there, and that is known as crossing angle. And this crossing angle is taken as alpha. Then the type of tongue rail used. Depending upon the tongue rail used, again the design of turnout calculations depend upon. Now, as I have told you, three leads are there. One is the curve lead, another is the switch lead, next is the crossing lead. Okay, so this is a figure which is very familiar to you. This is the main track. Okay, this is the main track. And this is the turnout, or you can say it is the track which is getting diverted from the main track. Okay, so this is denoted by the main track. Gauge distance is given by G. This distance is gauge distance G. Okay, now this is the turnout curve. So this point will act as a tangent to this curve. So this point is taken as T. Okay, so gauge distance G is given, and this is the point T, which is the tangent of the curve. Okay, now coming to curve lead. Curve lead means what? It is distance between the TNC and tangent point measured along the length of the main track, which means that you can see over here TNC. In the figure you can see TNC. I'll show you. This is TNC, that is theoretical nose crossing. And the distance measured from here to the tangent point, this is known as curve lead. So I'll tell you how it is measured, or I'll tell you that what is this lead, why we are using the terms lead over here. We know that, see, in this figure, this is the outer lead rail, this is the inner lead rail. Okay, so what we do is the lead rails being curved are not measured along the curve length, but they are projected on the adjacent straight rail. So you know this is the turnout rail, or this is the lead rail. They are being projected. This is the lead rail. It is getting projected. See, here it is getting projected. Here this point is there. So depending upon these, we are calculating some leads. First is the curve lead, which means theoretical nose crossing. I have told you all the calculations are based on theoretical nose crossing. So you are projecting it, so you'll be getting a point over here. This is the theoretical nose crossing. Distance from here to this is taken as what? The curve lead, and it is given by the letter CL. Now switch lead means it is taken from the tangent point T and heel of the switch. You know this is the toe of switch and this is the heel of switch. So if you're measuring this from the T point to heel of switch, what we get, that distance is known as the switch lead. Now coming to the crossing lead, it is the distance between TNC, that is theoretical nose crossing, and the heel of the switch. So this is lead, which means this is simply told lead, or you can say it is as the crossing lead. Okay, now it is measured along the length of the main track. So this total length is CL, this small length, that is from the tangent point to the heel, is SL, which is known as switch lead. From TNC to the heel of switch is taken as crossing lead. So if crossing lead is equal to SL plus L, switch lead plus crossing lead, sorry, curve lead CL. Instead of telling curve lead, I have told the term crossing lead. Remember, CL is the curve lead. This is equal to SL, that is switch lead plus the crossing lead. Okay, now that means the crossing lead will be equal to what? It will be equal to the curve lead minus switch lead. Coming to the different notations which we use for the calculations, first one is beta, which is known as the angle of switch, the angle between gauge faces of switch rail and stock rail. Then comes alpha, which is the angle of crossing, whether it is acute or obtuse, we take the angle to be alpha. D is the heel divergence or clearance. We know that heel divergence is the distance between stock rail and the tapered rail or the tongue rail. Next, R0 and R is there. R0 is the radius of outer curve of turnout. We have turnout on, from which is getting diverged from a main track. So the outer curve of turnout radius is taken as R0. And the turnout, you can put a center line. And if you're taking the radius for the center line of turnout, that is denoted by R. G means it is the gauge of track and N is number of crossing. Now totally we have three methods which are adopted for doing the calculations or design of turnout. We learned the first method. In the first method, all the three leads are calculated. Which are the three leads? Curve lead, switch lead and the crossing lead. In this, the crossing angle is calculated by right angle method. So we have gone through the different methods, that is center line method, right angle method and isosceles method. We know that the right angle method is being adopted for the Indian Railways. So the crossing angle is calculated from the right angle method. And the crossing curve is considered to start from the imaginary tangent point T. I have shown you in the last figure that a main track is there and the track is getting diverged, and the point where the main track and the point of curve meets, that there we have a tangent point T. Okay, now this results in three kink. We know what is kink. Okay, kinks are formed at the end of adjoining rail when they move slightly out of their aligned position. So there is a possibility of forming of three kinks when we have a crossing curve. One kink will be formed at the toe of switch, one at the heel of switch and other at the toe of crossing. So this kinks are formed because of the irregular wear of rail. I have told you this in the some videos before. That is, when you are having irregular wear of rail, when that diverging, when the rail is getting diverged to another rail, so in those portions kinks are formed. Now this method is adopted when G, D and crossing angle is given. That means in this method we are finding out the three leads, and this method is adopted when we are having all the three things, that is gauge distance we have, the heel divergence and crossing angle. When we have these three values, it is possible to calculate the curve lead, switch lead and crossing lead using this method. Now this is the figure. This is the main track, okay, which is having a gauge distance G. This is the main track, okay. This is the turnout. Here, this is represented by G. This distance is the crossing lead. This is the switch lead. Okay. Now, the entire thing, adding these two, we get the curve lead. And this curve is a turnout curve. When you're extending the lines and when it meets the point O, we can take the value as what? It can be taken, or the radius is taken as R. Now, R is the value which we have for the center line of the turnout. If it is taken or if it is measured from the outer curve, that value is taken as R0. Okay. Then we have this value. This is the crossing angle alpha by 2. Or you can say this entire value is alpha if it is so. A line is drawn through the center, then that is taken as alpha by 2. And if you are extending these three lines, that is the radius, then you will be getting this angle also as alpha. So here what we are doing is, from the geometry of figure, different elements are calculated. It is not necessary to go through the derivation, but we should know the equations for each element for solving the problem. Okay, so you should know the main figure. Which are the different leads and which is the R0 value, which is R value. So as I have told you, R is what? The radius measured from the center line of turnout, and R0 is the radius which we measure from the outer curve. Okay, so now let's learn the different equations for the different elements of this turn out. Now, curve lead is found out to be CL is equal to G cot alpha by 2, or another notation or another expression is there, CL is equal to root of 2 R naught G, or you can take CL is equal to 2 G N. Okay, so these three expressions can be used if you want to find out curve lead. These expressions are being derived from the geometry of figures, from taking each triangle, and I have told you, instead of taking the curve, we take it as what? Straight line, and things are getting projected to the main track. So from the geometry of triangles, the expressions are being found out. So curve lead can be found out from three expressions. One is 2gn, another is root of 2 r naught g, another is g cot alpha by 2. Now coming to the radius of turnout, r is what? It is the radius which is measured from the center line of turnout. So that r is equal to what? R naught minus g by 2. R naught is the radius which is measured from the outer curve of turnout, and g is the gauge distance. Now r naught can be found out from what? CL by sine alpha. Alpha is the crossing angle, or it can be used, or this symbol or this expression can be changed to CL cosec alpha. 1 by sine alpha can be changed to CL cosec alpha. Or you can also use what? Another expression, which is r naught is equal to 1.5g plus 2g n square. So these are the expressions, and different expressions are there. So depending upon the value or depending upon the elements what is given to you, you can find out each feature of the turnout. Now coming to the switch lead, SL, which is equal to root of 2 r naught d, then crossing lead L, or just simply lead, is found out from where? CL minus SL. I have told you first slide itself, which is equal to 2gn minus root of 2 r naught d. Okay, heel divergence is there, small d. That d is equal to SL square by 2 r naught. Okay, so these are different expressions which is derived from the figure, by taking the geometry of figures, by taking simply the triangles, and from those triangles we are finding out all the leads. Also we have found out the heel divergence. What we need is we have to do the calculations for the turnout. Now coming to the first problem, we have to find out the necessary elements which are required to set out a curve. Okay, so the question is given as, calculate all the necessary elements required to set out a 1 in 8.5 turnout. So you know that required to set out a 1 in 8.5 turnout is what? 1 in n. In the last video, I have told you what is n, what is crossing angle alpha. So in that I have told you, when we are setting out a curve, we set out in what? 1 in n value, capital N value. That n is what? The number of crossing. And here it is given 8.5. I have also told you that 8.5 is a common number of crossing which we adopt for the railways in India. Now taking off from a straight broad gauge track, since it is given it is a broad gauge track, G value will be what? 1.676 meters. With its curve starting from the toe of switch, that is tangential to the gauge face of the outer main rail, and passes through the TNC. Just remember the figure what we have seen some slides back. So it is told to find out all the necessary elements. Here the heel divergence is also given. D is equal to 11.4 centimeters. Okay, 11.4 centimeters. So what we have to find out? We have to find out the different elements required for setting out this curve. Okay, so you know, or from the given data, what we can write is N is equal to 8.5, G is equal to 1.676 because it is a broad gauge track. Heel divergence is given as 11.4 centimeter. Since every value is given in meter, let's convert it into meters. It is 0.114 meter. 11.4 centimeters is converted and it is 0.114 meter. Now we have to find out the curve lead, the radius, radius R, R naught, switch lead and the lead. So the first method what we have learned just now is for finding out all the leads. You can see over here, switch lead, then crossing lead, and we can also find out the curve lead. Okay, now curve lead is equal to 2gn. The simplest expression, we have three expressions. In that, the simplest expression is what? 2gn. So 2 multiplied by 1.676, which is the gauge distance, multiplied by the crossing number. We get it as 28.49 meter. Now coming to the radius r, r is the outer curve. For this we require r naught minus g by 2. So first we have to find out r naught value, and the r naught value can be found out from the expression 1.5 g plus 2g n square. So when you are doing the calculation, you will be getting 244.69 meters. Now we have got r naught, that is the radius of the curve, which is measured from the center line of the turnout. This is r value. Okay, now this r can be found out from what? This expression is given. You have understood this r naught value, and when you are substituting this r naught value in this expression, that is 244.69 minus 1.676 by 2. When you do this, you will be getting the radius of center line of the turnout. Next is the switch lead. The expression for switch lead is root of 2 r naught d. So which is equal to root of 2 into r naught value is 244.69 into d distance, which is the heel divergence, 0.114, which on solving we'll be getting 7.45 meters. Then the last lead, what you can found out is the crossing lead, or simply it is denoted by the letter lead, L. So it is equal to CL minus SL, curve lead minus switch lead, which is equal to 28.49 minus 7.45, which is equal to 21.04. So this is how you go for the calculations. So this is the method 1. So in the coming video, we'll have to learn method 2 and method 3.